drift speed in the terms of relaxation time. Drift speed, right? Relaxation time. Drift speed, right? In the terms of relaxation time. What is the relaxation time? What is the relaxation time? Relaxation time is represented by tau. Conductor is there. Electrons are there. Those are free electrons. They are in a random motion. Now I am applying the battery. Because of the application of the battery on the conductor, electric field is applied. There is a potential difference. In such a case, every electron experiences a force. Because of the force, every electron experiences the acceleration. Because of the acceleration, it will travel with the increasing velocity. As it is traveling increasing velocity, it go on colliding with the ionic lattice. Right? It may collide first ion. Next, after that collision, that is, it may undergo second collision. It may undergo third collision. It may undergo the fourth collision. The time interval between two successive collisions is called relaxation time. The time interval between two successive collisions is, what to say, relaxation time. Right? There is an electron. It is traveling with the initial velocity u. Right? Now, here, whenever the electron is traveling with the initial velocity u, right? Now, it will experience a force. It has the acceleration a. Acceleration a. After, after the first successive collision, means after the relaxation time tau, what is the velocity? That velocity is equals to v is equals to u plus at. Right? As the electron is traveling, it may undergo collisions. It may undergo collisions. The time interval between two successive collisions is called a relaxation time. Suppose electron undergone first collision, right? After undergoing the first collision, what is the initial velocity? U. Next collision is taking place, right? Between these two successive collisions, what is the time interval? That is tau 1. During this time interval, during this collision time, what is the force? Right? Experienced because of the force, there is acceleration. After that collision, what is the velocity? V is equals to u plus at. Now, after the second collision, again v is equals to u plus at. After third collision, again v is equals to u plus a tau. Now, after number of collisions, right? The average of all initial velocities is becoming zero. After number of collisions, instead of increasing with the speed, it will travel with the constant speed Vd and A into, what to say, tau. Therefore, already you know that, right? Every charged particle will experience a force. F is equals to EQ. F is equals to MA is equals to EQ. Therefore, A is equals to, what to say, EQ by M. Therefore, VD is equals to 0 plus A is equals to EQ by M into, what to say, tau. Therefore, drift velocity is equals to EQ by M into, what to say, tau. Therefore, this is the drift velocity expression in the terms of tau, which is called relaxation time. right? Next one, what is the mobility? What is the mobility? Mobility is represented by mu, that is mu is equals to VD by E. Whenever unit electric field is applied, whatever the drift velocity acquired is called mobility. The drift velocity acquired by the charged particle on experiencing unit field strength is called mobility. Therefore, mu is equals to VD by E. Therefore, now that equals to VD is nothing but drift speed. Drift speed unit is meters per second, right? Electric field intensity, volts per meter. Therefore, now here in this case, volts per meter. Therefore, meter square per second by that is volt. Therefore, mobility unit is meter square per second by volt. Therefore, the sum charges are easily move on the application of the electric field. Some charges are difficult to move on application of the electric field. With how easiness the charged particles acquire the drift velocity, how difficult the charged particles will acquire the drift velocity, it can be explained through a mobility. Mobility is a physical quantity. It is a ratio between drift speed to the electric field intensity is called mobility. Or otherwise, the drift velocity acquired by the charged particle on experiencing unit field strength is called mobility. Now, the mobility can be determined by the Hall effect. The units of mobility, that is drift speed, meters per second, electric field intensity, volts per meter. As the meter goes up, meter square per second, this is called volt. Therefore, meter square per second by volt, that equals to meter square per volt per second is the unit of mobility.